Hello, this is Jackie Schulerman, your Silicon Valley connection. I'm in downtown Palo Alto. I'm here with Mayor Liz Ness, and I would like to ask several questions from you. Mayor, can you introduce yourselves to our friends who are from all over the world so that they know who you are, and specifically that you've been a mayor for the third time, and that's astonishing.
So yes, I'm Liz Ness. I've lived in Palo Alto for a number of years. I've served on the city council now, closing in on 16 or 17 years, but not all at once. And I left at one point to be a county supervisor, and I've also served on our school board. So I have a couple of kids, and they have kids, and we are pretty well established here in the community. And we enjoy living here a great deal.
I know everyone loves to be in Palo Alto. Mayor, would you please tell us about your vision for Palo Alto?
So for Palo Alto, what I hope long-term is we continue our diversity, our vitality, and the sense of community that we've always had. We also are a beautiful place to live with trees, with good landscaping along our byways and highways, and I think also a great selection of restaurants and stores to shop in, as well as the renowned Stanford Shopping Center. So as we go forward, I hope to see, in addition to maintaining that which we already have, also I am an advocate for housing this year, and I'd be glad to tell you more about that.
Oh, definitely. We would love to know about that. And also, I know we're pretty much a pedestrian and bike friendly, but I would like to hear what your vision is and what you would like to move us toward, toward the housing, and also becoming more bike friendly and pedestrian friendly.
Well, I think we've moved a long way toward becoming bike friendly. About 50% of the kids in our high schools actually ride their bikes to school, which is unusual. And I think we've made great strides certainly in the walking and in the biking area. Where we are falling behind is in the area of housing. So if there's one area I'm going to emphasize this year, it will be housing. Housing of all kinds, housing for seniors, housing for teachers, housing that is primarily for the workforce, where we'll have smaller units and we'll have less parking. So I look forward to looking toward an array of housing that's different from what we've had in the past, although we have some terrific housing that is low to moderate income housing as well. Mm-hmm. And we have 1,600 units of that in Palo Alto. I hope we can add to that while I'm the mayor.
Wonderful. And what would you like for your legacy to be, you know, 10, 20, 30 years from now, when everyone talks about Mayor Liz Ness and what she accomplished? Especially being, as I mentioned, being our mayor for three times, which is amazing.
Yeah. Being mayor for three times, though, to be quite honest, is more about about staying in office for a long period of time than anything else. So what I would hope to leave as a legacy is just what I was discussing, a change in our housing outlook and a change in our perception of what it is and what we can allow for density. I would like to see us become somewhat more dense because we are a landlocked city.
Right.
We either have to go dense or we have to stop expanding in our city. And I'm not looking for us to grow enormously. I just want to see us grow with our housing opportunities in a way that we haven't been able to in the past few years.
Mm-hmm. So as a mayor, what are your challenges or the fun days that you would like to share with our friends?
Mm-hmm. I think one of the most satisfying parts of being the mayor is interacting with kids in the city. And I know that through the year, I'm going to see kids in a variety of different ways. They'll come in if they're Girl or Boy Scouts. They'll come in from some of the schools. And I hope that they'll bring some of their artwork with them, because it's always fun to have that and to put it up in the office. And so I think that is fun. It's also fun to greet new businesses, to cut the ribbon on their starting to enjoy Palo Alto as a business.
Right.
We just did that with the market in Edgewood last week.
Nice.
I did it yesterday with Hewlett Packard, who has started a sustainable garden with a rebate they have from the utilities department as a result of their energy savings. So that was very satisfying. That is the kind of thing, but the meat is going to be this year for me, concentrating on housing, transportation issues, because there are lots of traffic issues this year that people want to discuss. So I don't know what the legacy will be yet, but I think that as the year goes on, it will become more evident what it is.
And how do you balance the need between the housing and also the business? You know, we're the heart of Silicon Valley. That's where everyone, all the entrepreneurs would like to come to Palo Alto, because that's where the really the dreams actually come reality, and people are innovating constantly and they want to be here. So how do you balance that?
So some days I balance it better than other days. it really does depend. Some days are very, very busy, and other days you'll have a lull where you can reflect or at least read some of the many things I have around here that need to be read, our reports, our packet for next week. I think the balance is very interesting, because if you don't pay attention to that, other parts will sort of go astray.
Right.
So I'm very interested in being able to do as much as I can while I'm the mayor. And at the same time, for example, I'll be meeting my daughter for lunch today.
Oh, awesome.
So I want that to be part of the balance.
Yeah, and that's really my next question, was that how do you balance being a mayor and the demand on your time, and being also the head of the council, and your family time, and how do you balance the business and the personal life?
Well, I don't know whether I'm balancing it well or not. It's the end of the first, I've only been mayor, I think, for 3.5 weeks at this point. And I'm just beginning to get the rhythm again, because it takes some time to get in back into that mayoral rhythm where you know that you're responsible to the community for so many things. And people really look to the mayor to solve often the kind of issue that we cannot singly solve.
Mm-hmm.
So in that case, we really need to get the entire council together in order to work on problems like that. So I don't think I'll be solving everything, but I think I have a great council to work with, and I'm really looking forward to the year with them as well.
So to sum it up, what would be your perception 5 years, 10 years, 20 years from now?
I would hope that we will still be as vital a community as we have been. We didn't begin to have this sense of vitality until the early 1990s.
Okay.
And we have lots of challenges. Mm-hmm. We have Mountain View to the south of us, and they have been building a great deal. They've added a lot of housing, they've added a lot of commercial space, and they have Google that they're really partnering with for more housing, for more transportation, and almost for a whole new Mountain View out in North Bay Shore. So the same with Menlo Park. Menlo is also building up. So we've always enjoyed, in the last 20 to 25 years, a unique place, I think, in the country, even in the world. And I hope we can maintain that. I don't want to see us not be that exciting, vital place to come to work in, to play in, and to enjoy.
Right. And Stanford is so close to us. Do you work with Stanford hand in hand to bring more innovators to this area, and from technology or medical or any other area that we can share with our friends?
I think Stanford does that all by themselves.
Okay.
I don't think they need us to help with that, because they attract the best and the brightest, clearly. I think, though, that we do need to partner with Stanford. Okay. We have done that in the past. We're right in the middle now of Stanford wishing to expand their campus. So as you know, we're having responses to that. And, you know, it's really a chicken and egg.
Mm-hmm.
You know, we support Stanford. Stanford certainly is in our backyard or our front yard, depending
right.
on how you look at it. And we look to partner with them in a productive way.
And for our friends who might not be from the area and there might be all around the world watching this, can you give a sampling of who some of the big players are, small players, or the next emerging players that you are working with and encouraging them to do even more?
So if people don't live in this particular area, it might be interesting for them to know that Google is in Mountain View, just south of us, and that Facebook is in Menlo Park, just north of us.
Right.
And we have a variety of companies that are in Palo Alto, VM, Hewlett-Packard. We also have a downtown area, and not everyone is aware that Amazon has a large research presence here in Palo Alto,
yeah.
which is very interesting. So I think probably University Avenue sort of defines our area.
Right.
So I know in other parts of the world, they, when attempting to establish themselves as a sort of another Palo Alto,
yeah.
they almost always have a University Avenue.
Okay.
Which is fascinating.
Right.
So I know that there are parts of the world that simply have tried to replicate Silicon Valley, and usually University Avenue is right in the middle of their plan.
Right.
Isn't that interesting?
That is really interesting.
Yeah.
And
yeah.
I know I've been here for 16 years and I have seen that so many startups started here on the University
right.
Avenue
uh-huh.
and started branching out, and like the house and some of the others
uh-huh.
that they are now becoming very prominent and very well known
right.
in the area.
Yeah. So Facebook started downtown.
That's correct.
They moved out to California Avenue.
Right.
And now they're in Menlo Park, so they continued to grow and flourish, but they started here.
Right.
As did Google.
Right.
So yes, you're absolutely right.
Right. That's wonderful. Well, is there anything else you would like for our friends to know about Palo Alto or you as a mayor?
Oh, I think they've watched for quite a while. I would say if they've made it this far, I think they get a flavor of where we're going and understand how enthused I am about this, delighted to be mayor. And look forward to a very productive year.
Yeah, as I mentioned, I've been a resident of Palo Alto for 16 years, and I absolutely love the city, and I'm in love with Palo Alto. So I think this is going to conclude our interview here, and thank you so much for
taking time from
your very busy day meeting with me and sharing your day-to-day operation with the friends.
And I appreciate being asked to do this, and
thank
I'll
you.
Look forward to watching your video.
All right, well, thank you so much. Well, this will conclude. Please give us some likes or comments or feedback. I would love to know what your questions are, and then I will definitely pass that to our mayor, Liz. And should you need my information, is Jackie Schollerman, your Silicon Valley connection. My phone number is 650-855-9700. And also my email address is jackie@schollerman.com. Have a wonderful day.